gonna need some KY warming jelly for this one. This video's hot.
Being, you know, natural, big and shredded, it's kind of an oxymoron for us. It's like you can't be that. You can to some extent have a little bit of both of those, but mainly whenever we're big, you know, we have a layer of fat on us. Whenever we're shredded, you know, we don't have that fullness in our muscles to be able to look big and shredded.
Sorry, I'm not sure about that.
Whatever. But you know, it's something that we try to achieve, but it's hard to achieve because we look good with shirts off whenever we're shredded, but we look good in shirts and our arms look big whenever we're on a bulk and, you know, we're looking big and muscular, if that makes any sense whatsoever. But yeah, guys, I just want to get that out there, you know, into play. There's no such thing as any of those things. Your body repairs and it builds itself at night. That's the reason why sleep and rest is a huge increment to this little equation. You know, get your food right, get your exercise right, and get your sleep. Sleep is a crucial thing for building muscle whatsoever. If you don't have a good sleep schedule, more than likely your gains are going to suffer, or more likely your weight loss is going to suffer. Your body goes through these interventions within itself at night whenever you're sleeping and resting. The body will rest, the mind's still going, that's why you dream, but the body is repairing itself. It's going through this phase where, you know, the hypertrophy that you cause during the day to break those muscle fibers up, well, it's got to form some scar tissue in there to be able to make those muscles bigger. Also, same as fat, you know, yes, we breathe it out, but whenever we're breathing the most, you know, deeply intense is at night whenever we're sleeping, whenever we're getting the cellular respiration, we're getting everything going like it's supposed to. And that's just one thing that a lot of people don't understand in this industry. A lot of people try to teach false promises, I guess you could say. And the whole thing about this is being transparent. And that's something I want for you guys. If you're watching, you know, if you like it, like, comment, subscribe if you like this. But that's one thing I wanted to get out there, is just being transparent and being honest. Finding the right people to go to in this type of industry to get your best knowledge, where the science-based research and everything is in play, rather than just trying to tell you this big lie. You know, there's a bunch of bodybuilders out there that are, you know, IFBB pros that, you know, their diet's not going to work for you because they're shooting with steroids, you know, they're roiding up. They've got a bunch of stuff in their favors as far as supplements, you know. Their supplements that they take through their company that they're sponsored by, that's not doing anything for them. They're taking, you know, cycles of Tren, cycles of Anabol, Dianabol, you know, for their cuts, they're taking clenbuterol, you know, they're taking, what is that, DNP. They're taking dangerous stuff that's going to help them lose weight, but in the long run, it's going to have big side effects for them. And if you're a natural bodybuilder, you need to take advice from a natural bodybuilder, somebody that's been there, somebody that can learn, that you can learn through their experience. They can teach you stuff that they know, rather than trying to go to somebody just because their body looks good, you know. I know the image thing is attractive and all, but also whenever you're trying to get to your best self, you need to go through somebody that you can relate to. And I hope to be that for you guys, but there's a ton of people out there that is good. I'll give you some guys right now. You know, Max Tuning, he powerless, but you know, he's a great guy as far as if you're a skinny guy trying to get powerful and, you know, build. Max Tuning is a great guy. Christian Guzman, you know, he does summer shredding every year. So, you know, he gets his chart up there as far as like what his macros are and how he got to that. And he's a great guy. Vitruvian Physique, you know, Igor with Vitruvian Physique. He's a great guy too. I mean, he goes through everything. He throws out informational content all the time, whether he's getting ready for a bodybuilding show or, you know, he's just trying to be an athletic guy and just try to show you how he withstands his physique during those times. And he also gives you research, you know. He's a great guy. That those three guys right there is where I get a lot of my information from. One guy that I picked up as soon as I started getting, you know, into fitness, getting into health, trying to figure out what the crap am I doing. Mike Matthews with Muscle for Life. He owns his company, Legion Athletics. Great dude. He's got great content as far as, you know, taking a fat caliper, measuring your fat, or, you know, the science behind BCAAs, the science behind proteins, as far as whey isolate, or, you know, just whey protein, creatine. He goes through everything. I mean, the dude is a encyclopedia for fitness and health. So, you know, those are four key guys that help me on my base building blocks as far as getting started. Great guys. So, yeah, there's a ton out there, guys. And if you're watching this, look them up, you know, watch them. They're my inspirations from where I back some of my information from. Jeff Nippard is another guy. Look him up. He's got the science behind exercising and everything. What's optimal for building muscle, you know, as far as, you know, one video that he had that was real good was sugar. You know, is sugar inhibiting weight loss? You know, is it keeping you from losing weight? He's got all the science behind it too, and that guy right there is another good guy. So there's a ton out there for you guys to listen to. I'm just one of them that's getting started. If you, like I said, if you like my content, like the videos, comment, subscribe, you know, share these videos, get this information out there, because I'm one of them that is trying to be transparent also, but I've got to build from somewhere. These guys have already got a base to be able to give you guys a ton of information. So go to them, check them out. If you like me, subscribe to me. I've got new videos coming up all the time. Sorry that I've been a little absent this week. I actually believe I broke my big toe. Hit it on a cardboard box, and it just, you know, did its thing, the littlest things. But I'm good. I can still walk on it. I'm still doing cardio and stuff. I just had to take a little break throughout the week. That way I can actually buzz through it. But sorry for this long video right here, guys. I'm going to continue with this day of eating. I just wanted to put that little information in there for you guys, because it's been on my mind a lot lately, and I just want to get that information out to you guys. That way you guys can, you know, learn from it, build from it, whatever you want to do. But without further ado, guys, I'm going to ingest this protein shake real quick, get a workout. There probably won't be a video on my workout today, but there will be a video coming up with just, you know, workout content. That's kind of where I want to go with this. Have a day where I'm kind of show you guys what I eat, show you guys the progress of the diet, but also take a video, you know, take a day to be able to go in depth in my workouts to tell you what I'm doing and what's helping me, and also give you guys some workout stuff in case you guys have any questions or anything. But yeah, guys, I'll check in with you in a bit. See ya.
Welcome to the voiceover, guys, for today's workout. I just wanted to do a little voiceover and also show you the progress that is being made here. Today, you're going to see over the bench press workout that we're doing, I hit a new PR today for 255 on bench press for 3 reps. That is personally a new record since the back injury. I was up to 325 for 1 rep before the back injury, but you know, progress is being made every single day. The point of this video, as you guys see in the title, if you're viewing it, consistency is key. And that's mainly goes towards anything in life. You know, I don't know one successful person that had made it from being chaotic, putting stuff off till the last minute, you know, not doing stuff consistently, being chaotic with their and irrational, you know, just anything like that. I've never known anybody to be successful, whether that's, you know, job related, goal oriented, you know, fitness related, anything like that. Nobody has ever been successful off of being sporadic and chaotic. It's always consistency. So yeah, I just wanted to talk a little bit about that, you know, maybe preach a little bit about that, you know, maybe get it through your head, but also, you know, make you sick of it too. That's just the way that it works for me, and I'm just giving you the same way that I learn stuff. I want to talk about it with you guys. But yeah, this diet for me, being consistent, has been a little challenging. A few days before this, I felt my first burnout. I felt completely empty. I had no energy. I went to the gym that day, did some workout, and it was the roughest I had. It felt almost like I was sick because I was so low on energy because of the diet. And during those times, you know, a lot of people, whenever they're feeling that way, that's when they fall off the wagon. They're like, oh man, I've got to get something to eat and it cannot be anything diet. I have got to. That's when people typically go into binge mode. You know, they'll eat a whole pizza, they'll eat, you know, McDonald's, they'll anything like that. You know, they'll go fall off the wagon, then they'll feel absolutely guilty afterwards. But if you can just power through it, you know, do that, it usually only lasts for a day, especially just starting off like this is. Now, as I get further in it and get even more into competition prep and get even more into the depleted storages within my body, there'll be a consistent basis where it's just terrible. And, you know, that's just some of those days you have bad workouts and you have low energy when you're on a cut. And that's just the way it is. You just got to have the willpower to power through it. And, you know, that's where, thankfully, you know, the diet that I'm doing, the intermittent fasting with the If It Fits Your Macro integrated into it, that's where it's so great. Because, yeah, I'm low energy and I don't have anything. But if I just wait it out until, like, you know, say about 2, 3 o'clock during the day, you know, I can have all these nutrients that I'm needing to grab and be satiated and be just fine and replenished, you know, feel that way. And that's the benefit of that compared to if you're just feeling terrible and, you know, you're on the bro diet split of eating 5 to 6 meals a day. It's just, it can benefit you. It's whatever's comfortable for you. But also science and research backs it and states it, saying it doesn't matter about your meal timing, whatever you do. There's no anabolic windows. There's no protein windows. You know, none of that bro science stuff that has been disproved since, you know, at least 2000. But it's always about what's more convenient for you. If eating 5 to 6 meals a day and it keeps you, you know, it keeps you satiated throughout the day and it helps you along, and you're not really that type of person that come around 8 o'clock at night, you're starving because you've ate that those small meals throughout the day, that works for you. That's fine. But also on the other hand, the other person that isn't that much of a breakfast person, doesn't care about breakfast, they can skip that meal because that's just pretty much a wasteful meal. They're not hungry. They're going to be in the same boat come at the end of the night. You know, they'll be able to, if they're hungry, if they're that type of individual that's hungry at night, they can be able to fit more calories in before bed. Because, you know, that another myth, the 6 o'clock, don't eat carbs after 6 o'clock. That's a myth too. Your body replenishes, it restores, you know, it goes through cellular respiration, it rebuilds itself, the hypertrophy that is caused through a workout, it repairs itself through that, you know, it builds muscle tissue throughout the night. You exhale fat, you know, throughout the night. It's just one of those things that it's just simply not true. As long as you get your caloric intake just right, you have your macro split just right, it doesn't matter. You're going to be able to grow. You're going to also be able to shred. You're going to be able to do whatever you want as long as everything is calculated just right. Nobody's going to be any different than any other person. But hey, guys, that's it for me. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you like this video, like it, comment, subscribe, you know, hit the notification bell. But anyways, guys, enough of the black screen. This is it for Mediocre Fit. Peace out, guys. I'll catch you in the next one.